Hello everybody, you got inspired, you found the image you want to draw, or you created it from scratch. Let's get into all the steps you need to go through to ensure you will transfer your idea to paper in the most efficient and correct way possible. First of all, you should identify the size and shape of your canvas. In order to do that, there are a couple of elements that you need to take into consideration. The most important is your artistic view. What is your vision? Is it a simple portrait? Is your composition more suitable for a landscape canvas? Maybe you want to separate your canvas into two to create an effect. Once you decide on the shape of your canvas, then you need to decide on the size. Similarly, your artistic view is very important. However, this time, there are other elements that need to be considered as well. For example, the way you are transferring your image onto your canvas. If you are doing it freehand, then go ahead, you can do anything. If, on the other hand, you are like me and you need to transfer your image to your canvas, then you need to consider the resolution of your image. The better quality of an image you have, the bigger you can go. The problem lies on the pixel count. If your image is poor quality, then when you make it bigger or zoom to see details, you get a pixelated image that distorts your perception, and many times eliminates details altogether. If your target is to draw a reference with all the details, then you should be looking to end up with a high resolution reference photo. Once you ensure that you have that high definition reference, you can transfer it to your paper with any of the ways available to you. We have talked about transferring your image to canvas in a previous video. I have a link in the description. Another element that you need to take into consideration is that in many cases, the size and shape you select for your art is not a perfect match with the sizes of canvas you find in the stores. When I say canvas, I don't just mean literally canvas, but any medium you use. It could be paper or even a wall. So my solution for this issue is to either work with a medium that is flexible, for example with paper, I could have rolls of paper that I could trim to the desired size, or make my own canvas at the desired size, or I could just edit my reference photo to fit the medium. Most of the time, editing the reference to fit the canvas is way easier, so I use that most of the time. How do I do that? Okay, let's say I want to draw a portrait. And to start with, I want to make it as big as A3 paper. The dimensions of an A3 paper are 21 centimeters by 29.7 centimeters. Having that in mind, I select the paper I want to use from my stock. The closest to these dimensions is the Strathmore Bristol 500. However, this paper has dimensions of 27.9 centimeters wide by 35.6 centimeters high. So, in order to place my art onto the paper, I use software like Photoshop or Affinity Photo to get a preview of how it fits. This is the stage where I find mistakes or make adjustments to my reference photo to fit my canvas perfectly. So, in my software, I create a new project with a canvas that has the same dimensions as the paper that I selected. Before I do anything, I always make sure to mark a border around my paper because I do not like to draw at the edge of my paper. I usually use a border of 1 or 2 centimeters around, and that helps when I frame the art at the end. If I was using canvas, I would skip that step. After that, I import my reference image and resize it. so at least two of the edges touch the border. Now, in the case that the sizes match and my art sits perfectly into the border, that would be it. It would be ready for transferring. However, most of the time, there will be some discrepancies. For example, although the width might be okay, the height might not be right, so you will have to adjust. The decision on how to adjust is totally up to you. Use your creativity and always think what helps your art. The adjustment could simply be just resizing the image to fit your canvas, losing some information, or adding elements in your composition to fill the empty space. My advice on this is, with every decision you make, you should be looking to see if that decision makes your art better or worse. It is a subjective matter, so do what makes you happy. Once you're happy with what you see, it is time to transfer your art to canvas. Again, I will have a link in the description of the video that we talked about how to transfer your art to the canvas. In case you choose to trace it, you need to print it. Usually, we own printers that handle A4 sized paper. But what happens when, like in my example, the size of your art is bigger? Well, either you go to a store to print it at the correct size, or use something called tiled printing, where you can separate a big image into pieces that you print on A4 pages and then connect them with tape to create your size. The way I do it is this. I use Illustrator. I create a new project, just like before, with the dimensions of my physical paper. I import my reference I just created with the border and all, and then I press print. On the general tab, under options, there is a drop-down menu for scaling. You select tile imageable areas and the software takes care of the tiling. You have the option to move the image within the A4 pages you are going to print it on, and I use this to place my art in that way, so all the important elements are sitting on solid paper and not on any edge. If, for example, the face ends up on a cat, I might have some discrepancies when I transfer it, so I try to avoid it. After you print carefully, tape the paper together and use it to transfer your art. This is how I prepare my reference photo for drawing. If you have any tips you would like to share, go ahead and share them in the comments section below. That's it for today, guys. See you on the next one.